It's your face.
Oh, you can see that one's face and not the white one. Where are you? What is that freaking noise?
Be the dipping for the dinner. Make pour on the grill or cramp toast. All those things have a very concrete scent to them. Even if us, we don't necessarily smell food. A grizzly sense of smell is 7 times stronger than a hound dog sense of smell. So they're very capable of locating where that food is. So that's our goal for out here. If they come out, smell out where the food is hidden. You might also notice Spirits found an item out there. So this is something
look
that
we do here at
the Grizzly Service and Rush, the only facility that does this official container test. So this is a backpacking canister that is undergoing a test from this point on, where we are seeing if a bear can get access to the food that's inside of it. So any manufacturer who designs a canister like this, or a cooler, or a trash can, or a dumpster, anything that they believe to build to be bear resistant, if they want that official certification, it has to come through the bears here. So they send it here, we sell it with some food, usually something a little higher value, so it can be things like dry dog food, or fish, or peanut butter, or honey, and then we close it up and secure it exactly the way the manufacturer intended, and then have it out in the habitat. Now when the bears come out, they notice the food's in there, again, they won't smell that food. The goal is for this container to go through 60 minutes of bear contact without them getting a food reward from it. For it to pass and be considered certified bear resistant. The idea behind that is that a wild bear realistically not going to spend more than an hour's worth of energy attempting to get food out of there, no matter how good a food they smell. So the bears here, again, it takes them longer than that hour. It's not going to be all the same time. But out the wild, the goal is to keep wild bears wild and to prevent them from getting that easy access to food. So be things like if you're backpacking, just a food store, or one of those food attractions I mentioned before. If bears get access to them, they will remember getting that food for the rest of their life. And no matter how much time passes or how far away they're moved from that area, they will remember exactly where they got that food. In Spirit's case, that was her story a lot, was when she was a younger bear in the late 90s, she was seen a couple different times getting access to those foods in and around the town of Whitefish, Montana. So she was seen in residential areas, on horses, she was also seen in the golf course because the grass and water started to grow. So during the other times of the year, when the grass was kind of drying up, she was realized there was still easy food here. Well, they tried it. Instead of just relocating her 100 miles away and hoping that works, which is kind of the go-to method with bears getting access to food, instead they wanted to try this new technique called aversive conditioning. So they would track Spirit, but instead of moving her a huge distance away, they move her right to the edge of town. The goal was to have her still remember exactly where she was, what she got to in there, and then as they released her from the trap, there'd be people around who would start shouting and yelling or shooting off rubber bullets or cracker shots, making her pretty scared and stressed, and so she would try to leave that area. The goal was to get her to start running away. Now, because people are not nearly fast enough to keep up with the bear, but they wanted that stress to keep following, they used Karelian bear dogs, a special breed of dogs, specifically bred and trained for bear management, to follow along behind her, not directly behind, but far enough along where they can keep her moving because all that stress in her mind is following her, and it's a very specific path the dogs kind of guide her along. Once they get to a certain point, they stop, all that stops, and the goal for them is that Spirit is that she remembers all those bad things happening to her to hopefully overshadow the good memory of food, and has a good idea too, good memory of where she just ended up, that all of those bad things stop, and hopefully in the future she does not want to return back to those food sources. It is one of the more effective bear management techniques out there. It is, again, can be used, but it's very resource intensive. And for Spirit, it did work for a little while, but in 2002, there was a drought year. Food was very hard to find. And so she decided to overcome those fears she had of getting back into those areas, and she started finding food again in those residential areas where people, again, were not super used to seeing a bear around. Because she started to lose her fear of people and lose her fear of roadsides, that resulted in one of her cubs that first year, when she was 6 years old in 2002, resulted in one of them getting hit and killed by a car. Shortly after that, she abandoned the second one. It's not uncommon for first-time moms, especially when something like that happens. She herself has been picked up as a food-conditioned bear, a bear who has lost her fear of people, has changed her behavior, cannot be out in the wild any longer. With the majority of those bears every year, it's also a lethal removal that has to happen. That happens about 80% of food conditioned bears every year. But in very specific situations where, again, the temperament or history of the bear is just right, and there's space and captivity, captivity can be an option. So Spirit arrived here in 2002, and she's now 24 years old, so on the older side for a bear. But again, we do kind of learn a lot more about the natural lifespans by seeing them in situations where the cause of death is not going to be anything to do with people, which again is the leading cause of death out in the wild. I think what's weird out here, so she does know there are other foods hidden around, but those are kind of a lower reward, but they are lower risk. So moving around to get a bite, again, can be worth it, but spending this kind of energy is only worth it if there's something really good inside of there. So again, the goal for us is just going to be watching her do this process, and even if she stops, we just stop the time has to add up to 60 minutes, and seeing her try to get into this container, and again, hopefully she does not get any food out from it, or create a hole large enough to get food. All those things can cause that test to be a failure. If you have any questions, though, about this testing process, or the bears, or anything else here at the center, just please feel free to let one of us know. My name is Leanne, I'm one of the naturals here. My coworkers will be kind of around throughout the day as well. I always enjoy watching spirits. We want to thank everyone so much for joining us this afternoon. I also want to thank everyone for your continued use of your face mask. Again, we're recording it on indoors and outdoors because we are a small facility. So we have noticed it got a little crowded in the viewing area. And so this is something that's helping us stay open as a small facility. So we really appreciate everyone's help with that. Again, any questions, let me know. Otherwise, have a great rest of the day.